Yo, ladies and gentlemen, I'm MC Cinnamon, and welcome back to the second Space Engineers Weekly Workshop Roundup. And just like before, I'm bringing you all the hottest ships and all the hottest mods for this week. Now, I would usually bring you three ships. However, this week, there's going to be four because there's a bit of extenuating circumstance. You see, these three ships here in the center of the screen, the USS Victory, the USS Chimera, it's not actually the USS Daedalus, it's the USS Chimera and the USS Argon. These guys are actually all from one mod, the Star Trek themed ships mod by Attila the Honey Badger. While these ships are Star Trek themed, it says in the description, they are not canned by any means and do not represent any lore-based ships, but still, even to the most uneducated of people, you can tell that this right here is the Enterprise. I have no idea what the other two are based off of because I've never watched Star Trek. Star Trek is just not something that, well, I it seems I would enjoy. But anyway, the other mod that I'm... the other ship, rather, than bringing you guys today is the Elysium. It's the Elysium by Wasted Space. That guy is, he's a mobile base, so you can go and park him over asteroids. We're actually going to test him out soon enough, but you can actually park him over asteroids, and he's got all of the mining equipment that you might need and stuff, and he's actually got two places to park ships, one right here and one right here. This one doesn't actually have any docking connectors, it doesn't look like, so maybe this is just for regular ships, not necessarily mining ships. And then over here you have docking connectors for any ships that require them. So we're actually going to turn this guy back to front, because at the back is engineering. If we go down here and we open this door right here, well, it's already open. By the way, I do want to apologize to you guys for not actually uploading a video when I said I was going to. I tried to make a video that day, but the video that I made wound up absolutely sucking, so I decided to just go ahead and scrap it and refilm it. But anyway, so yeah, this is engineering. You've got all your batteries here. It's a battery-powered ship. You may have noticed the solar panels on top of the ship, so it just stores energy, rather, from the solar panels in these batteries, which power the reactor, so you should have pretty much infinite fuel, which is always nice. And then back here, you've got your gravity generator up there, your single gravity generator that generates an entire half G. And your secondary cockpit, so that way, in case, for whatever reason, you get your main cockpit destroyed, you've still got a cockpit to be able to control your ship from. And yeah, the Wasted Space actually said that this is his main cockpit that he uses, not intended as such, but this is what he uses regardless, because he can see the entire ship. Doesn't have to worry about crashing into anything. So yeah, back in engineering, your main reactor, all of your fuel storage stuff, your gyros, and all of that, basically just your normal average engineering bay, although I really wish it was connected to the rest of the ship, because Tally would not be pleased having to space herself just to get into the engineering bay. So, yeah, that's engineering. Now, this is the main sort of landing pad for ships that don't really require docking connectors, like I said before. And here's a warhead for reasons. We've also got passenger seats back here. I don't know why that is. Anyway, so if we go up here, then this is the upper level of your storage area. So you've got a reactor, that powers this this conveyor here, and then this conveyor runs down below deck into some storage crates that are under here, and then your med bay is right here, so if you die you can still get your stuff relatively easy. That's pretty nice. And then more batteries. Now here are the solar panels I was talking about. So this ship usually comes its own separate world, and when you hop into the cockpit on that world, you've got a bunch of buttons on your hotbar that allow you to control the solar panels. However, if we were to hop into the cockpit here, then we wouldn't have those, because I've actually taken it from its native world and pasted it in with these guys just so it would be easier to review all of them in one fell swoop. And then here's another gyro. This thing actually turns pretty well. I'm not gonna lie, for a large ship, well, technically a large ship, I mean, it's not the biggest we've ever seen, but it actually turns pretty well. So yeah, it's actually got literally everything you need for a mobile base, except beds. If you want to go ahead and place down a couple of beds from the bunk bed mod. I think, who is it that makes the bunk bed mod? I can't remember. But yeah, if you want to download that, put a couple of bunk beds down there. Then I haven't actually been below deck, but there may be enough space down below deck for you to sort of make a makeshift living area. Not that it matters right now, because there's no reason to sleep in space engineers, and you don't have hunger or anything. So yeah. And then I guess these guys, or these terminals here, exist to actually control the solar panels, I believe. That doesn't look like they do anything just yet, but I believe they may actually be there to control the solar panels. And I do actually like that this is solar powered, because, well, of exploration, pretty much, because you're not always going to be near an asteroid. Once you get out into the far reaches of space, you're not always going to be near an asteroid. So if this thing were to run out of uranium, then you'd be up Crab Creek without a paddle, in that case. So it's nice to have these guys here to give your ship power until you can reach another asteroid and fuel up your mining craft that would be parked here. So it's pretty nice. And I do like the whole aesthetic of the ship. It's got a nice view out. I do wish the glass was clear, though. That would be even better, but hey. And of course, now we come to the main cockpit. By the way, this is your main storage area for just all your stuff. And this is the observation deck up here. As you can see, there's not really much going on this, I'm not gonna lie. It's just a regular old observation deck. Maybe, you could come up here and just sort of have a look around. It's always very nice to just have a look around, when your ship's got the inertial dampeners off. You could just explore, basically. Just go outside and have a nice look. Maybe come up here, have a space cigarette, and look at Earth. Yeah, that's actually a nice skybox, by the way. And then, last but definitely not least, you have, your main cockpit. And, whether or not you use, I will say this, whether or not you use the rear cockpit or the front cockpit basically comes down to a matter of if you want to be more immersed in the world. Because, using the rear cockpit gives you a better view of the ship. You can see the entire thing, but here, you know, once it's first person, so you can actually look around and you can see quite a lot, so you can tell that this is built to be as immersive as possible, you know. So, yeah, we're going to test the speed of this thing out, and as you can see, for a large ship, it's actually accelerating relatively well. I'm cracking 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20 meters a second there in a relatively short period of time, so that's nice. And turning is not terrible. It could be better, but it's not all that bad, all things considered, because this is a really long ship. So we're gonna turn and we're gonna head back for the Star Trek guys over here. Turn the other way, turn the other way, turn the other way. Inertial dampeners. Oh, there we go. Turn the other way. Stop. Okay, so actually getting it stopped and then turning it the other way is not very easy at all. But it is, it does actually have a decent turning rate, so it's definitely usable. So we're just gonna head back to Victory right now, and then we're gonna review him, then the Argon, then the Daedalus. Because I know you all want to know what the Enterprise looks like on the inside, so I'm gonna troll you all. I'm gonna troll you all and review the Enterprise looking ship last, because I'm mean. You're welcome. So while this guy's getting stopped, we're gonna go ahead and hop out. We're gonna go over there and start reviewing some Star Trek themed ships. And here we are at the USS Victory. Now this is the fast sort of attack ship that came with the Star Trek themed ships mod. And yeah, as you can see, it's fairly basic on the inside and the outside, but yeah, it's not too pretty in here. It's meant for speed and maneuverability, so it's just got the bare minimum stuff. Now we come down here, we've got crew quarters. This is, by the way, down the ramp to the right-hand side of the door on the left, or the airlock on the left. So we've got crew quarters and the entertainment area. We've got your TV, billiards table, and bunk beds for all your crew, also your lockers and everything, and crew storage up there. So, yeah, it's just, well, it's just, as you can see, it's very basic. It's none too luxurious. There's a lot of noise, and it's very, very industrial feeling for something that's based off of Star Trek. So, here, I believe, is your main reactor core with reactor terminals right here. Yep. So, how? Why must you be in every video I make? You evil son of a bitch. Alright, yeah, anyway, so this is your main reactor core. You would use how to actually control these reactor guys. I believe they're reactor guys. They're from a mod, I believe, so I'm not too sure on what they are. But yeah, we've also got decorative little pylons here that would, if they were interactive, they would allow you to control the reactors a bit further. So, and then on the other side of this, we're gonna go up the stairs in a second. On the other side of this, well, there's nothing really. I could have sworn that there'd be crew quarters down there, but apparently not. So this is your refinery here. And you go up here. Now this is actually engineering, my bad. These guys probably are, I don't know what they could be. I'm not entirely sure. They're from a mod. I've never seen them before, so yeah. But up here, this is engineering here. That's your main reactor. And then here, here are your reactor rods and stuff. So this is where you actually control the reactor. And listen to all the sci-fi awesome sounds. Those are really cool, I'm not gonna lie, those are awesome. And then up here, well, this is the mess. I use the term very loosely, but yeah, it appears to be the mess / space coffee area. Your break area, that's what this is. This is your break area. So you've got your books, your info terminal to look up prawns on the extranet, and then here's starboard airlock. And finally back here, the weight room. Yep, the weight room, the lockers, and these guys. Yeah, these guys show up quite a lot in these ships, I'm not gonna lie. Again, I don't know what they are, because I've never seen them before. I've never seen them on the workshop. So, I don't know. They're probably from the workshop, but I'm not entirely sure. So, this is the shower. And that's literally all it is. Literally all this is the shower. But, so, I believe this is the last room. Let me go and just make sure of that real quick. Now we've got another room here. Oh, this is the captain's quarters here. So yeah, your bed, your chest of drawers, and that's your captain's quarters. That's literally it. So wait, you've got a commode on one side and showers on the other? Sure. Whatever floats your boat. But over here, this is the last room, I'm pretty sure. It's just the bridge where you can control the ship, and it's got a lot of stuff for exploration and a lot of other awesome sci-fi goodness. Now this, I seriously cannot get over the way this looks. This looks ridiculously cool. Doesn't look like something you'd find in Star Trek, but I'd be surprised if they had actual, like, Star Trek terminals or anything, even on the workshop. So, yeah, this is the same rain meter looking stuff here. And if we hop in, you can tell that it's actually slower than the Elysium. Just a hair. And it's less maneuverable, but it's very well armed. It's got phasers. If we switch to them there and then fire them. Just listen to this, okay? Just listen to this. That is so ridiculously awesome. I cannot believe how awesome that is. And then of course you got traditional missiles. One traditional missile turret there. So it's not very, that's not very heavily armed. This is a fighter ship and it's only got one missile launcher, and the radar detection system is not working, whatever that is. Oh, and one thing that all ships have in this mod, before I forget, they have red alert systems. So, and the ship creator, Attila the Honey Badger, actually recommended trying them all out, so just behind this door. Oh, more captain's quarters. So I'm gonna go and I'm gonna try to find them. Try to find the red alert system. It doesn't look like it's here or here. This is your med bay, by the way, with weight room. So I don't know. I don't know where the red alert system is on this ship, but maybe you can find it and give it a shot yourself if you actually do find it. But I've got other ships to review right now. By the way, yeah, this is a functioning hangar bay, complete with hangar door. If I could find the controls. I actually had to open that up to get in. So, if I could find the control to close that guy, I just got hit by that thing. If I could find the control to close that guy, that'd be nice. Or no, it was actually, I believe it was the Argon that I had to open the door to get in. So, yeah. And then, speaking of the Argon, we're going to go and review that guy. And I'm going to get back to you. Well, we're already here. Never mind. Stop. Inertia dampeners. Thank you. Hi, Siri. Sexy girl. Yep. She's my signature ship, in case you're wondering why she's here and we're not reviewing her. And now this, I have to warn you, this is the most sci-fi awesome cacophony of sounds you'll ever hear that's about to grace your shit, to grace your ears. So brace for it and prepare to get the anti-face melting medicine out, because you're gonna need it. Was I or was I not right? That was ridiculously cool. Oh man, that was awesome. So, yep, we are actually now, you come straight into engineering, and then you've got your reactor there and your cargo container for the reactor. No, actually, this is, I believe this is for the, I believe this is for the ship that docks here, because this is an exploration vehicle. Well, I say an exploration vehicle, it's actually a mining carriage. So you park your ship here, connect it to this docking connector here, transfer the stuff through here. You've actually got refineries under here as well, so you could either, I believe you can either shoot straight through the conveyor system into there in your cargo container, or you could use the refineries and make some stuff. So, yeah, that's what all this is, and I believe off to, to either side of the main reactor and the main cargo container, we have the gyroscopes. There are three on each side. Your crew, some crew bunks, right here in engineering, right next to the main reactor and the main cargo container. So all I gotta say is these dang things better have some amazing sound deadening built into them. This would have to be like thick sound deadening, especially on the curtains. Yeah, that's ridiculous. And then this, I believe, is, well, this is a sector map, so I'm not sure why that's like that. You'd think that the computer down here would actually be a control of the main reactor and the main cargo container, but it doesn't actually look like that's the case. Here's your gyroscope, not your gyroscope, your gravity generator, hidden away under the main reactor. And then on the other side, that's just more the same. You've got your gyroscopes, your random sector map, and your control station, and crew bunks. I don't know why in the world you'd have your bunkers there. And then this would be your mess. Your crew would have to subsist off space coffee, which, I could actually do that all day, because I actually had the chance to sample some of the space coffee off screen. Let me tell you, dead tech, space coffee is the way to go. It's just perfect for space, because I live aboard a space station with my xenomorph wife. Here's the bridge. These guys are actually the red alert systems. So, I believe that signals the all clear. These blue lights signal all clear. And then these are the red flashy lights saying, hey guys, we got a problem, we're being attacked or something. And then that's the siren. Shut up. And then shut up. Okay. Or shut up. So okay, so that one turns off the siren. So blue light signal the all clear there. Red flashy lights, siren, and then turn off the siren. So we're just gonna turn the red flashy lights off. Here's your captain's quarters complete with shower, and then down here you got your storage. Although I'm not exactly sure how you'd reach it with normal human hands. And so you got your shower there, and then I don't know what exactly that's for. I don't know, and then you got your med pack there for if you're injured and you need to heal up. And your info terminal. And that's your captain's quarters. I believe that's almost all the ship. If you these guys are airlocks, yes they are. I could have sworn though that there was a party area. I don't know, maybe that's on the map, maybe that's on the Chimera. Interesting, I could have sworn to you that there's a party area on the ship. Yet, by the way, loggers too, in case. Well, I did forget to point those out. So, yeah, that's pretty much this entire ship. Now we're gonna head over to the Chimera. If I can avoid getting whacked in the face all by that thing. Yep, that's the Argon. By the way, love the rotating nameplate. Oh! We actually forgot to test this ship out as far as acceleration is concerned. You can already see, I don't even have to try this out, you can already see that this thing is a ridiculous amount of cargo space. I mean, look at this big boy here. A huge amount of cargo space, and I believe it's got two refineries on the bomb side. Or, the bomb side, the back side rather, so it's got more than enough refinery stuff. And this actually looks like it's even faster than the fast attack ship. So, whoops, I've accidentally pressed T. And now I'm floating in space. So V is what I meant to press. There we go, yep. It's even faster than the Victory. So this should be your attack ship, but it's not. And turning, as far as turning is concerned, decent enough for a big ship like this one. And yeah, so turn the other way and then it actually doesn't take forever and day to stop. It doesn't look like. It just takes forever. And that's the Argon review. That's pretty much the entire ship. I'm counting down for all my life is worth. There we go. There we go, indeed. So, bang! We're going to hop out of this ship and then we're going to hop into the Chimera. Finally. Yes, I know. I'm a master troll. You can stop giving me burnt art now over just now getting to it. And yeah, I will get back to you after this. I also have to figure out what's happening to my voice. Why is it going so high? There it stopped. So, here we are aboard the Chimera. Now these... Excuse me. I had to swallow a bit more sweet tart taste there. Anyway, so yeah, this is the Deep Space Exploration Vehicle. So, as you can guess, it's the most well-rounded of the three vessels in the Star Trek-themed ships mod. Well, I say three. If you count this guy, it's four. This is the Daedalus. And what he does, he goes, and, well, he's a mining ship, as you can see by the mining drills on the front there. Very light. If you fitted this guy with some phasers or something like that, some missile turrets, he probably actually wouldn't be an entirely terrible light fighter. So, you could easily convert this guy into something that would actually help defend you. If, you know, if you got separated from the other ships in the mod. And then around here, these must be like storage or something, but around here is the dock supervision area. Might as well just call it air control. So here's air control, and this is where you can direct the pilot of the Daedalus from, so you can tell him you've got a little bit to go before you're at the docking connector, you know, you need to move left, right, whatever. And it's got another one on that side, so it's not really worth mentioning. And then it's got HAL, and also some of these. I believe this is, well, that does this. These must be sensor blocks or something like that. I'm not, sound blocks, maybe. Though these guys look like sound blocks. I can't be exactly sure. I have no idea what they are. I've never seen them before. But then down here, we just have some storage containers. I believe it's the exact same on the other side. Hold on. I'm going to go verify that for you guys, because it's been more than a day since I've actually played this. So yeah, these guys, it's just two storage areas on either side of the ship. And then we go over here. This is the med bay. You've got your medical, beds here, your dead tech medical beds. Dead tech makes a lot of awesome stuff. And then your desk with holo computers, just so that you can, well, do computery stuff for patients, like plug their names into the system. And then med bay is complete with skin changers, like they all are, MCZ. They all are. They all have skin changers. So, duh. And then this is the captain's quarters here. Well, I believe there are actually two captain's quarters areas. So this must be for elite crew or something. But you got your big TV, your info terminal, your huge chair that's way too far away from that table. Yep, this is, good lord, I feel like I feel massive. I feel huge sitting on top of that chair, just like you usually do when you sit on a bar stool. You know? And then your blue lights, just to give the place a little bit of spacey ambiance. Down here is engineering. You've got your big reactor and your gravity generator, your stats screen, and just ways to control these guys here. So yeah, very, very nice. I love the aesthetic of, especially these interior walls. They look so, they look really exquisite. Just really, really, really nice. So over here you got your rec room, complete with a ping pong table, white benches, and fake plant, more white benches, and then, yeah, that's the bridge, we'll get to it in a second. But then up here, I believe, well, this is, at least the group quarters, that's a toilet, not the group quarters. Yeah, here are elite group quarters. I can't remember exactly where the other regular crew quarters are. So, yeah, on the other side here, this is the upper level of engineering, by the way. Oops, can I not fall through there, please? Yeah, and then more elite crew quarters up on the other side. And then, so yeah, it's 32, sleeps 32 crew, rather elite crew members. So it's just a huge amount of crew members. And then this is the main sort of elite recreation area. You've got, well, slash party area, let's be honest. This is the elite mess hall here, and then you've got, a little bit of a place to sit and enjoy the view of Earth or wherever you're exploring. And then off to the side, you've got space coffee and books and monitors and your background table thing here. And then I'm actually going to try to find room quarters before I review the bridge, the regular crew quarters, because they're here somewhere, I think. Are they here? Nope, these are just the showers. And, yeah, so the med bay again. Oh yeah, here they are. So, these are the blue collar crew quarters here, complete with lockers and stuff. So as you can see, it's a very well outfitted ship for long range exploration and survival. And yeah, so this, I believe, it sleeps 30 blue collar crew and 32 white collar crew. So. Nice, you got your load with your sink here. And that's all the ships reviewed. Now, I've got three other mods there. They all sort of work in conjunction. Well, I've actually got plasma rifles too, which is another mod that I was gonna show you guys, but I may or may not have an opportunity to show that, but. So, yeah, the three mods that I've got, they're sort of working in conjunction, are Invaders plus Kill Counter by Arara, which basically, in new worlds where cargo ships are allowed, it spawns in hostile ships that periodically try to come and aggro you. And then, Cargo Ship Strikes Back by Sven, which basically gives cargo ships a very simple AI routine, where if you go and aggro them, they'll actually turn and face their weapons towards you and try to evade as much as possible. And then, a special note before I actually get into this new world, rename your ship, because if it has the word large in it, it's gonna the game will deem it an enemy ship, which is always fun. Trying to just get aboard your large frig with the word large in the name, and all of a sudden it turns against you and decides to be evil, and that always makes my day, doesn't it? You, it just always makes my day. And then there's one other one here. My apologies. There's one other one here. RST Encounters. Yes, that's the one by UL Phoenix. It's an alternative configuration of more endless LSF cargo ships and ships from the Imperium. And what it does is it adjusts the ship spawn rate to provide a more performance-friendly environment for decade servers. So if you've got a decade server, then this is a particularly awesome mod by, reducing the ship spawn rate and also dropping their speed down to 5 meters a second. So it adds ships from the LSF cargo ships mod into the world, with a few fixes and balancing changes to make them work nicely together. Specifically, some ships that don't have arms, like guns and stuff like that, missiles, GATs, interior turrets, and so on, they now have those. And it does... It does quite a bit towards, just making cargo ships a little bit more immersive, and also The version I have retains the standard vanilla base spawns, station spawns, rather. So I'm going to create a new world, I'm going to hop into that one, and hopefully these guys will work together. I say that because they're definitely gonna, they're definitely functional mods. However, with RST Encounters, the ship spawn rate is actually dropped down to one ship every 30 to 45 minutes. So they may not actually, well, I may just get bored of playing the waiting game. 45 minutes is ridiculous to wait for a ship spawn. So if I don't actually get to showcase those mods, then I will definitely link you to other videos that do showcase them, because they're awesome. The concept is just awesome, because that is a bit of an immersion breaker when you happen upon just some cargo ship and it does nothing to actually try to stop you. So yeah, if I don't get to showcase those guys, then if you like this video, then go ahead and bitch slap that like button. If you really, really liked it and you want to see more, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Hey, I've been NC Zinman. You've been awesome. I'll see you guys in the next video. MCZ out. And as you can see, a hostile ship has spawned in. I believe this, just off of a hunch, I believe this may be a ship from the Invaders plus kill counter mod, but we're going to go ahead and head for this guy using our FDGF Dragonfly. That is, I believe, well, it's somewhere. Yeah, let's go ahead and head for this guy, and maybe we can show off the, cargo ship strikes back mod. That would be pretty dang awesome. So hop into the FDGF Dragonfly, and here we go. We're going to head for this guy. Our insanely loud guns are armed. That's nice. These things better be as good as they sound. Oh yeah, that they do sound awesome. I will admit that, but we're gonna go and we're gonna actually show you the AI, this guy. Just so you can see exactly how he works, because he's gonna try to avoid us. He's gonna try to orientate his main weapons to us. He's also gonna try a few basic combat maneuvers as well, just to trying to defeat us. I am kind of nervous we don't have any missiles, though. That's a bit of an issue. And he's going to have missiles as well, if the RST mod has anything to say about it. I believe the RST mod actually adds missiles to these guys. I could be wrong. I probably am entirely wrong, but yeah, we're gonna kill this guy, no matter what it takes, so that way I can actually show you the kill counter from Invaders plus kill counter. So now I'm closer to you. We are well outside of weapons range. But yeah, he's actually gonna be a little bit more difficult to take down than just your regular fighter. I mean, not fighter freighter. So yeah. We're gonna get the 850 meters. And what I like about this mod is it seems to have adjusted so that the missile turrets actually lead their aim in case you're trying to circle straight. So yeah, we're trying to avoid those missile dudes. Oh, he's hitting us with gas. Yeah, he's... Yeah, see, they're leading their aim because they've detected that I'm moving, and so now, you know, they're trying to compensate for my momentum. I don't believe that happens in the regular game. I wonder if we're actually getting any hits in on this guy at all. Because it certainly doesn't seem that way. There we go, we're getting some good hits in on him now. Seems to be a bit of a weak spot down here. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, we're turning into him now. He has no bottom defenses. So we're just gonna sit here and we're gonna camp. And we're gonna wreck all of his stuff. Yep, that's his gyro going. He can't actually get a beat on us because we're below him. There he goes! For some reason, the kill counter didn't actually show up, but... Yeah, so, that's pretty much all of them. You can see that that his missiles were actually leading their aim a little bit, and he was actually turning his ship to try and get a better beat on us. He was also going a little bit slowly, because that's less resource intensive. The game doesn't actually have to keep up with him. So, unfortunately, the name of the world is literally, hopefully ships will spawn. But I have, in the process of showing you guys this, completely lost myself, but that's probably the last. Oh, no, here we go. I believe that's a home base there. But yeah, that's probably gonna be the last I ever play this world. But yeah, as you can see, RST Encounters, Invaders plus Kill Counter, and Cargo Ship Strikes Back. If you want more immersive sort of cargo ships, this is the way to go, by far. It just brings the level of immersion, when you're dogfighting a cargo ship, to an extreme level. Yeah, there we go, that's home base. It just brings it to an extreme level compared to what we've had previously, so it's just awesome, really. So I'm definitely going to be keeping these mods around. So if you like this video, then go ahead and bitch on that like button if you really, really like it. And you'll see more. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Hey, I've been MC Zinman. Series been series. You've been awesome. And I'll see you guys in the next video. MC Zinman out. It's the one that's only-